U.S. real yield surged at the end of February, spurring unpleasant memories of the taper tantrum in 2013, when comments by Ben Bernanke, then chair of the Federal Reserve, set off a 100 basis point rise in 10-year Treasury yields over several months. Now, as then, market expectations of the future level of policy rates have jumped sharply. In contrast to 2013, however, the Fed has made it clear that it does not intend to tighten policy until the unemployment rate is much lower and inflation sustainably higher. The market's apparent disbelief stems perhaps from strong economic data, including retail sales, news on greater vaccine availability, and anticipation of the $1.9 trillion stimulus package that has now been approved by the U.S. House of Representatives. Equities, meanwhile, have dropped over the last couple of weeks, although this is at least partly due to the fall in inflation expectations. We do not see price pressures waning quite so quickly. Commodity prices are still rising, and there is significant pent-up demand and cash in the economy even before the third round of stimulus checks arrive. The main factors keeping demand in check are lockdown restrictions and consumer anxiety, but both should diminish as we move into the spring. Rising real rates and higher policy rate expectations do not necessarily threaten the rally in equities we have seen since last March. While higher interest rates do mean a higher discount rate on corporate earnings, higher rates also reflect stronger growth and inflation. Historically, that benefit has outweighed any financial drag. On the pandemic front, the optimism that gripped the world with the announcement of positive vaccine trial results last November has been tempered. More infectious virus mutations and delayed vaccine rollouts have pushed back the date when lockdown restrictions are lifted and people feel safe enough to return to work, shopping, and recreation. Even as lockdown restrictions are reduced in some countries, activity remains subdued. However halting, progress is nonetheless being made, with over 30% of the UK and a quarter of the US having been vaccinated. Continental Europe continues to lag significantly, with just 7% immunized so far, but the rate should accelerate in the coming months. A bigger concern, perhaps, is the even slower pace of vaccination in emerging markets, which could delay the resumption in activity investors anticipate in the second half of the year. With low and rising interest rates, it is not surprising that investors anticipate higher total returns from equities than from bonds and have commensurately higher allocations. The latest AAII survey shows an allocation to equities of 67%, only modestly above average. Given the gap between the equity earnings yield and real bond yields, this allocation seems appropriate. Our asset allocation changes this month were to go overweight emerging market equities and overweight Italian equities versus the Eurozone. We reduced our commodities overweight and rebalanced our silver allocation to gold. Finally, we went overweight the US dollar versus the euro. For a full description, please see our asset allocation monthly on our website, investorscorner.com. That's it for me. We wish you a successful month and take care.